The main instrument for this process is this 1 minute for ourselves. We do various practices during this time. It can be 1 minute of silence, or 1 minute of listening, or 1 minute of feeling our body, or watching our thoughts and emotions, or 1 minute of connecting with other living beings. As you can see on this slide, I introduce also mindful strategies and wise reflections. And in a later slide, you have the opportunity to listen to students who are guiding some exercises for their colleagues. Here you can watch two video examples of my colleagues' students from a first grade class guiding each other through mindfulness exercises. In the left video, Timon, Fabian and Andreas are trying out a kind of candy meditation using the intense taste of a candy to really connect to the present moment. In the right video, Alina is guiding her classmates Leila and Lisa through a breathing exercise. One of the mindfulness strategies is grounding. It's a very simple and powerful exercise. It's about feeling the ground beneath your feet or coming to the sensations of the body. You can dive into the feeling that you are carried, that you are supported. And if you do this, you will notice that it's very helpful to calm you down a little bit. If you want, you can listen to Celine, who is guiding her colleague into a kind of grounding exercise. Another strategy is tracking. Here it is all about body sensations and focus on some neutral or pleasant sensations and watch how they change or how it stays the same over some time. If you want it, if you have time, you can listen to the voice of Rebecca guiding this kind of exercise. If you notice that you are stuck in the low zone, you maybe will find very helpful the next strategy. It's about resourcing. It's about recalling an internal, external, or imagined resource and bringing it into life in your mind. And if you want, you can listen to the voice of Shili. She's guiding a little practice of resourcing. On this slide, I share some feedback I got from my students connected with this minute of silence we are doing together. And this is very interesting for me because when we are doing it, not all of my students are really into it. There is some resistance sometimes. Maybe somebody has a hard time putting his or her smartphone aside, or some of my students are still discussing little things during this ritual we are doing. So I learned from this positive feedback, despite of all the obstacles and difficulties connected with this little practice, my students still love it. And that was amazing for me because it encouraged me very much to keep going with it. Slowly, we are coming to an end, and I hope you got an impression of how little exercises or small adjustments or even intentions can make a difference, especially if we think about it in the long run. So I hope these little impressions can inspire you to find your way to bring something good into this world. If you are looking for further inspirations, there are lots of materials and books around. And two of them I would highly recommend. First is Toolbox is You from Maria Kluge, her center in Osterlo, Germany. The book is written in German and in English. It has posters integrated. You can download the whole book for free, and it's really nice and playful to work with the toolbox. And if you want to dive in really deeply, you can use the C-learning framework from the Emory University. I cannot go into details here, but my examples in this presentation are very much inspired by this curriculum from the Emory University. So, finally, we come to an end. I thank you very much for your attention, and I wish you all the best.
Let's sum it up. Mindfulness offers students a way to regulate themselves by teaching them simple techniques. 1 minute of silence can allow us to experience positive effects, like a fresh perspective on upcoming tasks. Students can take active roles themselves and guide their peers. And trying out new mindfulness ideas is a step-by-step process where great things can start from small beginnings. Finally, leading by example, teachers can cultivate a positive mindset from within and inspire others.